Being a Christian means you're part of a family. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. From Mumbai to Manitoba, from Tokyo to Toronto, from Johannesburg to Rio, it doesn't matter where you were born, if you're rich or poor, or what language you speak. When a person accepts what Jesus Christ did on the cross, they become part of a family that's over 2,000 years old. But just because they're part of a new family that stretches around the globe and goes back a millennia, it does not mean that their problems just disappear. In fact, your problems become our problems. Your issues become our issues. Because that's what family does. It takes care of one another and takes care of the problems that everybody has. Now, why am I talking about this idea of Christians being a family? Because there's a topic that's rolling the United States right now in which many so-called Christians are not defending their family, their brothers and sisters in Christ. Confederate statues commemorate a period of time in this country by which one group of people fought to subjugate, oppress, and keep in bondage members of my family on the simple reality that they were blessed by God to have a different shade of skin color than me. So when my family, my brothers and sisters in Christ, come to me and tell me how these symbols of a failed rebellion are being used to implement and uphold the same ideas of xenophobia, of racism, of bigotry, I take a stand for my family, for my brothers and sisters, and say, tear them down, root and stem. I do not understand how this is an issue for Christians. As I have walked on my journey of faith, I've come to understand what being a Christian truly means, and I am flabbergasted that this is not a clear black and white issue for anyone who calls themselves Christian. The racism and bigotry that these statues represent belong in a history book, not in public parks or in courthouses, where members of my family are constantly reminded that they were and are considered second-class citizens in this country. When somebody decides to join the body of Christ and become a Christian and take Holy Sacrament and be baptized, their rights and responsibilities of that nation are the same rights and responsibilities as me. It is a moral failure of Christianity to not demand the same treatment for all members of our family that reside in this country. Christians today in my country do not even know what it means to be part of the family of God and the sacrifices that come about as a result. They do not realize what being a Christian truly means, that they have died to their old self and the old way of doing things, that they have died to their history and their heritage that they were born into, that they have died to their political ideology, that they have died to being Republican or Democrat, that they have died to left or right. These things are nothing but idols of Satan that they cannot serve anymore. As Christians, we serve the crucified and resurrected Jesus Christ and his kingdom and his family. And we speak on behalf of this family when the godless horde would use a statue as a symbol to further debase and demean members of this family. Like, subscribe, and share. Thank you for watching. God bless.